Everybody, it's summertime. I hope you're getting out there and doing some great stuff outdoors. This morning I'm gonna do some tennis with my friend. Gotta work on the casting arm, you know. Today I have a goal. I wanna do kind of a catch and cook type of a video. And I wanna go to the river, try to catch a trout. I hope I catch one so I can cook it and share it with you. And first trick is to catch the trout. So let's see if we can do that. Okay, see you in a bit.
There's a really nice big fish in there. I can't tell if it's a bass. Oh, he sees it, he sees it. Oh, he took a nibble. Wow, that was cool though. It's like two or three of them hanging out in that trench right behind the timber. Okay guys, I'm gonna try real worms and see if a trout will actually go for it. Sorry about the leaves in the way, but I'm in a nice shaded area and I can sit here and be camouflaged. Perfect cast, right in the depth. Oh, he's going for it, I feel it. Oh no! He stole it. I felt it, man. But man, they're very light biters. Oh, this is fun. This is fun. It's a game of cat and mouse. Okay, this is a pretty lame looking worm. I'm sure they'll love to eat it anyway. There he is. To the top left. He's gonna swim back up. Don't worry. Don't worry. There you go. Right there. Stupid leaf is in the way. Where are you? Oh, holy. Oh, oh, you see that? That was a beauty. It totally went for it. Okay, I got their attention now. You see it? Is that a beauty or what? Okay, changing it up to a 2-inch night crawler, pinched night crawler by Gulp. Down we go. Let's see. Yeah, they are smart. Oh, whoa, that felt like a really good hook. I actually pulled its head. But he wasn't on it. I have to use a real worm again. I'm using half a worm this time. Oh my god! I got it! Beautiful smallie. A little dirty, but I got this guy. This is awesome. Prove to myself that I can try to sight fish, cast it just in front of their face, and get a reaction bite out of them. And I'm gonna try to release this guy. You can breathe. Oh, wrong way, dude. That way, that way. They stock trout here in the early spring, and they get nice and big as the summer goes along. That's what I was hoping. I saw a really big trout, but instead I got a smallmouth. So what I used is a small circle hook. I put a split shot at the end of it so I could cast it out because the worm and just the hook is not heavy enough to cast very far. That gave me more accurate casting distance. And so I cast it upriver, let the current take the worm down to the mouths of the fish. The trout were experimenting with it, tasting, but the smallmouth is the one that committed. Let's see if I can catch that trout. I want that trout, man. I want dinner. Ooh, right over his head. Ah! Oh, I think I got it. I think I got it. Oh my god. Don't let it go into the timber. Oh, this is a heavy fish. You see that? Oh my god, this is beautiful.
This might be my first trout. Oh God. First trout ever. Holy sh**, I can't carry it up. It's in the sand. This is really heavy, guys. Oh, I got it. Holy sh**. There's so much sand on you. This is my first trout ever. Wait, that's pretty slimy. This trout is 2.5 pounds, 18 inches long. 18 inches long. I used my bass equipment first time around. It took me a half hour, but I caught a smallmouth. And then I came back to the spot after I released the smallmouth. Smallmouth are not really good to eat. Grill's nice and hot, 300 degrees. I put some oil on it so that the fish won't stick. But first I'm gonna put the shrimp on because I wanna get some nice grill lines on it. I basically used almost the same seasoning as I did for the trout. Salt and pepper, lemon, olive oil. And now I'm gonna put the fish on it. Use a nice long spatula. Putting it skin side down first. And that's what it looks like so far. Don't mess with it too much, they say. The spatula should only touch it once to flip it and once to take it off the grill. And I'll close it. Keep it closed for about 6 minutes, then I'll check on it. Looks nice. Flip the shrimp. This might be the tricky part because the fish might fall apart when I do this. Nice. Don't poke and prod too much. It's a very delicate fish. Looks good. On this flip side, I won't do it at 8 minutes. I would do it a little shorter than that. I'd say about 5-6 minutes. Be very, very careful. We're getting trout off the grill. Yep, nice and easy. I think we're ready to eat. Everybody take your seats. We're having fish tonight.
Okay, time to try this out. Come on now. Behave. Stay where you are. It came out really good because it's very simple. Tuna has an awesome flavor to it by its own. All you need is salt and pepper, lemon, and optional, of course, red pepper flake. Just enough to give it a little kick. I made some extra shrimp just in case the fish didn't come out right. No, come on, get off there. Okay, thank you. They stock rivers and lakes near you. Try it out yourself. It was an awesome day. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please subscribe. Please like if you enjoyed it. And we'll see you next time on my Outdoor and Nature channel.
You want more? Okay. Here you go. Yeah.
Success.